In terms of the actual external signals that the main ones that we know about that cause autophagy, a lot of them have to do with nutrient sensing.
Exactly. So perhaps the most physiological way to induce autophagy that is phylogenetically conserved from yeast to primitive animals to ourselves is nutrient deprivation, starvation, hunger. And so the idea is that a cell that is deprived from its energetic supply, which can be the absence of nutrients or the absence of growth factors that are required for these nutrients to be transported from the outside world into the intercellular space, or the absence of oxygen, all these factors can induce autophagy, and the cells actually will destroy its bioenergetic reserves, which are macromolecules, proteins, lipids, and ribonucleic acids to generate energy.
And in terms of the energy part, I was reading about like three really major pathways that seem to lead to autophagy, one being the actual energetic charge of the cell, like ATP status. When that lowers, that activates the AMP kinase pathway. And then the amino acid sensing pathway, which then when you don't have enough amino acids, that can basically inhibit mTOR. And then there's a third one, the protein acetylation pathway, which I'm not as familiar with how that activates autophagy.
So it's actually extremely easy. When you think about basic biochemistry, one of the central metabolites is acetyl-CoA. And so the cytosolic pool of acetyl-CoA determines the level of protein acetylation for the simple reason that acetyl transferases, which use the acetyl moiety of acetyl-CoA to transfer it on lysine residues in proteins. Acetyl transferases are having a low affinity for acetyl-CoA as compared to kinases, which have a high affinity for ATP. So if you vary the ATP concentration in the cell, it has little impact on phosphorylation reactions. But if you vary acetyl concentrations, it has a major impact on the acetylation level of cellular proteins. Mm. So that's a major difference. And so since acetyl-CoA is built in the degradation of glucose, the glycolytic pathway from pyruvate, or in the catabolism of branched amino acids, as well as a final product of beta oxidation, all major nutrients are actually supplying acetyl-CoA as an end product. And taking away glucose or amino acids or fatty acids will cause a reduction in the acetyl-CoA pool, and which is important to note, it is the cytosolic acetyl-CoA pool that is accounting for autophagy regulation. And this reduction in acetyl-CoA in the cytosol will cause deacetylation at the end of cellular proteins, hundreds of different proteins, and hence a sort of multi-pronged induction of major sub-pathways of the apoptotic process. Autophagy is actually a very complicated process that involves dozens, perhaps hundreds of different proteins, and is regulated by hundreds, perhaps thousands of additional proteins. And so this common regulation by acetylation is very efficient in stimulating the autophagic pathway.